Good day. So today we will be discussing about the first law of thermodynamics. So topic 5 na po tayo, hindi na po topic 4. Topic 5 will be the first law of thermodynamics. Okay. So let's go. So what is first law of thermodynamics? So as you can see in the video or the in the presentation, there is a fireworks display. So yung fireworks natin is nilalagyan natin ng apoy, tapos lilipad siya and then sasabog siya. So ano yung nangyayari? So we have a celebration here. So this is a conversion of energy. So mula sa chemical energy, kasi yung ating mga fireworks ay may mga mga powder na nilalagay sa loob. So yun, chemical yun. So those are chemical energy. And then pag sumabog yun, gagawa siya ng heat energy and sound energy. Pati light na rin, di ba? So you are converting chemical energy into heat energy or any other forms of energy. So the first law of thermodynamics, ganun din. So it is the conversion of energy. So let's see. So first, on the first picture, we have an electric fan, tapos sinaksak siya sa ating electrical outlet. So, nagkakaroon siya ng electrical energy, and then iikot yung motor sa loob ng fan, and magkakreate siya ngayon ng mechanical energy kasi magbibigay siya ng blower, or magbublow siya ng hangin. So, magiging chemical energy siya. Diba? So, we are converting electrical to mechanical. So, yung picture naman sa, pangalawang picture naman sa baba, so, meron tayong heater. So, pag sinaksak natin yan mura sa ating electrical supply, so, yung electrical energy is converted into heat energy. And then, pagkatapos nun, pwede nating initin yung tubig or kung ano man yung gusto nating initin using the heater. Di ba? Okay, so next, we have here, meron tayong isang container, tapos nilagyan siya ng may hangin sa loob ng cylinder. So, yung hangin na yun, pag nilagyan natin ng apoy or iniinit natin yung hangin sa loob, syempre yung gas sa loob niyan is nag-e-expand. Pag-expand niya, di ba, Bebe? Okay. Pag nag-expand siya, yung heat energy mo is nako-convert to mechanical energy kasi napapaangat niya yung piston or yung mechanical part sa loob ng cylinder. So, pag, for example, ginawa natin yung piston. So, yung piston na yan is nakakonekta dito sa bilog sa taas. So, nakakonekta siya sa kanyang crankshaft. So, pag angat nung ating piston, dahil sa init, so, iikot yung ating crankshaft. And pagkatapos ng pag-angat, syempre, pag nawala na yung init, bababa siya ulit, iikot na naman. And then hanggang sa tuloy-tuloy, init, tapos lamig, init, lamig. So, ikot ng ikot lang yung ating piston. Oy! Umiiyak na. So, here, the heat energy of fuel is converted to mechanical energy. So, this is how your car engine works. So, ginagamit natin sa loob ng ating piston and crankshaft is the first law of thermodynamics, which is conversion of energy from one energy to another. So energy can neither be created nor can be destroyed. So hindi tayo Superman na kaya nating mag-create ng energy or sumira ng energy, but we can transform this energy from one form to another. So yun yung posible na pwede nating gawin. Okay, babe? Oh, so this means that the total amount of energy in the universe remains constant. So I will also tell you why it is known as the law of... So it is also the law of conservation of energy. Kasi yung energy sa universe is constant lang yan. Nag-change lang siya ng form, pero hindi siya nawawala, hindi siya nagbabago, hindi siya nawawala or hindi tayo nakakapag-create or nagde-destroy ng energy. Okay, so tinatawag din siya na the law of conservation of energy, yung first law of thermodynamics. Di ba, Be? Okay, so the first law of thermodynamics, so there are different kinds of energy. We have a heat, we have chemical energy, we have mechanical energy, we have electrical energy. So the energy can be of different form, but all these energies can be converted from one form to another. So for example, the heat energy of the sun is absorbed by the plants in the form of chemical energy through photosynthesis. Here you can see the conservation of heat energy or into chemical energy. So the energy is just transformed but from one form to another. Di ba ba? Okay, so kagaya din ng mga pictures kanina. So it is just a conversion of energy. Okay. So, nakikita natin yan. So, when this rocket is ignited, it moves up in the sky and it bursts in the sky. Diba? So, it's simple. The chemical energy of the rocket gets converted into heat energy and sound energy in the sky. And also, light energy na rin. So, this is how the first law of thermodynamics or law of conservation of energy appears here in this example. Okay. See that light? Diba ba? Okay, so let me tell you something interesting. So there are two more classification of energy. So we have the kinetic energy and the potential energy. So ano ba ang pagkaiba ng dalawa? So kinetic energy is the energy which an object possesses due to its motion. So yung kinetic, yan siya yung energy in motion. While yung potential energy naman is the energy stored in a body due to its position with respect to some other body. So, this stone is at some height. So, naka-steady siya dyan. For example, tinapon mo, nag-steady siya bigla dun sa pinaka-highest part ng pagtapon mo. So, naka-potential energy siya dun. Pag bagsak niya ulit, so, magiging kinetic energy na naman yun. Okay, so, meron kang bato. Hinahawakan mo yung bato. Hindi gumagalaw yung bato. Di ba? So this is potential energy or energy at rest. So nagpapahinga lang yung energy dyan. So pag binagsak mo yung bato, nagiging kinetic energy siya. Okay, so there are different forms of energy. So for example, from the sun, nagiging solar energy, ginagawa natin chemical energy through photosynthesis by the plant. And then kinakain ng baka. So, nagiging chemical energy ulit. And then, pag sila namatay, yung mga plants and animals, pag yan namatay, so nagiging, nako-convert sila into oil. So, pwede natin gawing, siya yung nangyayari, yung mga petroleum natin. So, yun oil. So, yun naging chemical energy 3. And then, from the oil, you can create electrical energy using generator. You can make mechanical energy using engine and different forms of energy. So, nagko-convert siya from one form to another. Diba? So, ganun yun. Okay, so we saw that law of conservation of energy is energy can neither be created nor can be destroyed. But transformation of one form into another form can be possible. But in terms... Oh, yes. But in terms of heat, internal energy, and work, the definition statement of first law of thermodynamics can be stated as the net change in total energy of a system is equal to the heat added to the system minus work done by the system. So, let's make an example. So, for example, ikaw ay nag-gym. So, syempre, pag nag-gym ka or may ginagawa kang strenuous activity, umiinom ka siguro ng energy drink. So, yung energy drink na yon, so yun yung energy na nilalagay mo sa yung katawan. So, that is Q, di ba? So, yung Q na yon or yung energy na yon is iniinom mo, pumapasok sa loob ng katawan mo. After some time, yung energy na yon, pwede mo na yung gamitin to do work. So, for example, magtatrabaho ka. So, E is the total energy. So, meron ka ng ininom na amount of energy, Q. So, ready ka nang mag-work. Pero hindi ka pa nagtatrabaho, di ba? So, nagkakaroon ka ngayon ng total energy, which is E1. Okay. So, pagkatapos, nagtrabaho ka or nag-workout ka, so, ano mangyari? Mapapagod ka. So, nababawasan yung total energy mo. Yung iwan mo is nababawasan. So, pag nabawasan na yung total energy mo, nagiging E2 siya or it becomes E2. So, that's why para makita natin, yung total energy mo, babawasan mo ngayon, energy mo, babawasan mo ngayon nung ginamit mo na energy, so nagiging heat added, so yun yung Q, minus work mo. So the change in total energy is equals to the heat added minus the work done. So kung ilan yung energy na ininom mo, nabawasan ng trabaho mo, ng tinarbaho mo, or ng workout mo, so nagiging yun yung energy na natira sa'yo. Diba? So yun yung net change or yung energy na natira sa'yo. Diba? So ganun lang kasimple. Parang nag-gym lang tayo, be. Diba? Okay, next. So what is heat? So how is it related to the first law of thermodynamics? So heat is, napaso siya, ang init. So what can you see in this above image? So the boy touches the hot flame by mistake and he feels very hot. So napaso siya, be. Okay. So napaso siya. So yan yung heat. Dito naman, so kung titingnan natin, napaso siya. So yung init mula sa apoy is napunta sa kanya. Lumipat sa kanya, kaya siya ang napaso. Diba? So ngayon, titingnan natin. This cute boy is feeling cold as he is holding ice in his hand. So I want to ask you a question. Why do we feel cold or hot? So bakit tayo napapaso or nalalamigan? So thermodynamic plays an important role here and this will make you understand the concept of heat very easily. So when someone touches the hot flames, the thermal energy of the flame enters the body of that person because the flame is hot as compared to the human body. So mapapaso ka. But think about the second case. When you touch the ice, the case is completely different. Iba naman. So the thermal energy will pass out of your hand. So yung init galing sa kamay mo is papupunta doon sa, lilipat doon sa ice. Bakit? Kasi mas higher yung energy mo, may init ka, yung ice wala. So lilipat yung init mo papunta sa ice. Pag nawala na yung init sa kamay mo, doon ka na lalamigin. Diba? So that's how it works. So energy or heat flows from the higher energy level to the lower. So galing sa mainit hanggang papunta dun sa lamig. Ganun yung flow niya. So ganun na yon. So heat is simply thermal energy in transit. So parang nagmo-move lang yung thermal energy mo. So very easy, isn't it? Now let me ask you a question. I feel hot because heat enters my body from the surroundings. So tingnan natin sa unang picture. So bakit ka nainitan? Kasi mainit yung surrounding. Ngayon, kung gusto mong yung init mo, yung na-feel mo na init is lumipat doon sa ibang part or sa hangin, so lalapit ka lang sa electric fan. So pag nasa ice ka naman dito sa picture number 2, my body loses heat so I have to wear jacket. So, para yung init ng katawan mo ay hindi lumipat dun sa surroundings, kailangan mag-jacket ka. Uy, pagod ka na ba? Okay, so, let's pause for a while. Let's continue. Okay, so let's continue. Kasi yung boss natin is may pacifier na. So, yun. Kaya tayo nagja-jacket dun sa winter. So, pag malamig yung area, nagja-jacket tayo para yung init sa katawan natin is hindi lumipat doon sa surroundings. Kasi pag lumipat sa surroundings, lalamigin ka at magkakasakit ka ngayon. Diba? So, remember that 1 calorie is equals to 4.18 joules. So, we have 2 different kinds of pictures here. So, kung yung system is mainit and then malamig yung surroundings, lilipat yung init mo or yung energy mo, Q energy, lilipat doon sa surrounding. So that is negative. So nagbabawas ka ngayon ng heat. So heat loss 'yon. Pero pag malamig yung system and then mainit yung surroundings, so lilipat yung init mula sa surroundings papunta doon sa system. So that is heat supplied. So nagdadagdag tayo ng heat. Okay, so positive yung heat na pag ganyan nangyayari. So what is internal energy in first law of thermodynamics? So this section is quite interesting. So let's take a simple example for understanding the internal energy. So in this image, you can see that the glass is filled with water. So what do you think about these water molecules? So do they remain steady or they perform any motion? So yung molecules sa loob ng tubig, syempre, gumagalaw. Yan, di lang natin nakikita. So, meron silang tinataglay na internal energy, di ba? So, well, the water molecules performs various types of motion like rotational, vibrational, translational. So, if we increase the temperature of water, then these motions also increase. And because of this, the kinetic energy of molecules also increases. So, pag iniinit natin yung tubig, di lang natin namamalayan, pero gumagalaw siya ng mas mabilis yung galaw ng molecules sa loob. So, nagkakaroon ng kinetic energy of molecules. Pero, napapansin natin yan, pag kumukulo na yun, gumagalaw na talaga siya. Doon natin napapansin talaga yun. Pero, kahit na hindi pa yan kumukulo, gumagalaw na talaga yan. So, you can see that the molecules are also bound with each other with a force of attraction and they also experience a repulsive force. So, these attractive and repulsive forces indicates the potential energy. So in short, the molecules of all the objects possesses kinetic energy and potential energy, and these energies are present among the molecules. So what is internal energy? So internal energy is the sum of all the molecular kinetic energy and the sum of all the molecular potential energy. So parang total energy din siya. So internal energy is associated with the temperature of the object. So the temperature is higher, then the internal energy is more. Or higher. If the temperature is lower, then the internal energy is lower din. So a system does not contain heat, but it contains internal energy. So hindi lahat ng bagay mayroong heat talaga na laman, or hindi siya nagtataglay ng heat, pero it contains internal energy. So depende na lang kung paano natin i-move yung internal energy na yon. So what is work? How is it related to the first law of thermodynamics? So because it is very important for you to know about work for understanding the applications of the first law of thermodynamics. So let me ask you a simple question. When can we say that work is done? Kailan ba? So when a force is applied to any body and if that body moves in the direction of applied force, then we can say that work is done. So pag naigalaw natin yung isang bagay, merong work na nangyari. Kasi parang trabaho lang yan. Pag wala kang nagagawa, wala kang natatrabaho, so wala kang work, di ba? Parang si Juan lang, Juan Tamad. So nag-antay lang siya na mahulog yung bayabas, so wala siyang work na nagagawa. Di ba? Pero pag kinuha niya yung bayabas, so meron siyang work. But how will you decide that the thermodynamic system is doing work on the surrounding or surrounding is doing work on the system? So who is doing work on whom? Okay. So in order to decide this, let's consider a piston cylinder assembly as shown below. So yung piston natin, meron yang gas sa loob. Tapos, sa loob ng cylinder may gas. Tapos pag nilagyan natin yan ng heat, mag-expand yung gas, gagalaw yung piston. Pag galaw ng piston, yun, work na yun. So see here, the pressure of the system remains constant because as heat is applied, the volume increases and thus the pressure remains constant or maintained inside the system. So the work done by the system can be obtained from following formula. So work is equals to pressure times velocity 2 minus velocity 1 or pressure times the change in velocity. So work is equals to PV. So what should be the sign of this work done? Should it be positive or negative? So positive work ba siya or negative? So syempre positive kasi may When the volume of the system increases, then we have to take sign of work as positive. This is a work done by the system. So, palaki yung space, positive yung work. Or yung volume pala, pataas yung volume. When the volume of the system decreases, then we have to take sign of work as negative. So, pag paliit ng paliit yung volume, so, yung work is lumiliit din. Diba? I hope you have clearly understood when you should take work positive or negative in thermodynamics. So, example problems on the first law of thermodynamics. So, a system receives 224 joule heat and does work of 156 joule. Calculate the change in the internal energy. So, i-minus lang natin yan. So, 224 system minus the work of 156 joule. So, we have 68 joules of internal energy in the system. Okay. Example number 2. At 1 bar pressure, the volume of gas is 0.6 liter. So, if the gas receives 122 joules of heat at 1 atmosphere pressure, the volume becomes 2 liters. Then, calculate its internal energy. So, to calculate, pressure is equals to 1 bar. So, initial volume of gas is 0.6, while the final volume of gas is 2 liter. So, if you want to multiply, work is equals to pressure times the change in volume. So, the change in volume is 1 bar times 1.4 liter. So, that is 1.4 liter bar. So, convert that into joule. So, magiging 141.85 joule. So, the work is done by the system. So, work is equals to 141.85 joule. So, i-convert natin ngayon. So, the heat obtained by the system is 123 joule. So, according to thermodynamics first law, the internal energy is equals to Q minus W, which is equals to 122 minus 141.85. So, yung internal energy sa loob ng ating, kasi internal energy is negative 19.85 joule. Okay, maraming conversion pala dito. So, are you okay? Okay, so meron lang isang bagay na hindi niya re-recognize yung first law of thermodynamics. So sabi sa first law of thermodynamics, energy can neither be created nor can be destroyed, but transformation of one form into another form can be possible. Now, the machine or device which does not obey this first law of thermodynamics is known as a perpetual motion machine of first kind, PMM1, perpetual motion machine of first kind. So yung machine na to is hindi na ino-obey yung first law of thermodynamics. Kasi as makita natin sa picture or sa GIF na yan is tuloy-tuloy yung ikot niya kahit na wala ng energy or wala ng internal energy na nilalagay or heat or wala na tayong binibigay na energy sa kanya. Tuloy-tuloy pa rin yung ikot niya kasi meron na siyang momentum. So, hindi niya ino-obey yung first law of thermodynamics. Okay, you can see this picture. The device keeps on rotating its own. It never stops. So, hindi siya nagpumapara or namamatay. So, that is the PPM1 or the Perpetual Motion Machine of First Kind. So, but wait, how is this possible? So, we have seen that energy can't be created. It can just be transformed from one form to another. So, if we are not giving an energy, then why does this device keep on rotating? So, bakit siya umiikot? So, this type of machine is impossible. This device does not obey the first law of thermodynamics. This is the reason why such machines are known as perpetual motion machines. Practically impossible daw siya. So, note, perpetual motion machines are practically impossible. So, there are limitations. So, limitations of first law of thermodynamics. So, the first law does not say anything about whether the process is possible or not. Diba? So, hindi sinasabi sa first law of thermodynamics na Possible ba siya or hindi? For example, in engines, heat energy of fuel can be converted into useful mechanical work. But we cannot convert the mechanical work back into fuel. So hindi natin pwedeng ibalik yung fuel, di ba? So di siya reversible. So such a reverse process is practically not possible sa first law of thermodynamics. Okay, number two. The first law of thermodynamics does not say whether the process will occur on its own or not. So hindi sinabi na kusa ba siyang mangyayari or hindi, di ba? So let me ask you a question. What will happen if you put an ice on a table? It will melt down after some time on its own. So now, what about the reverse process? Magiging ice ba siya ulit? Will this occur on its own? The answer is no. So unless na ilalagay mo siya sa ref, babalik siya, di ba? So parang pag-ibig lang, di ba? Pag naubos na, hindi mo na kayang ibalik pa. Ganun pa. Ganun? Ganun ba, be? Okay, next. So, the first law does not provide any sufficient condition for a certain process to take place. So, for example, we have already seen that heat always flows from higher temperature body to lower temperature body. But the reverse process is not possible and this is automatic process. But what do you think is reverse process possible on its own? Can we transfer heat from lower temperature body to higher temperature body without doing anything? Do we need to supply anything to do this? Diba? So, hindi rin pwede. So, even the first law of thermodynamics does not say anything about this. So, in order to solve all these limitations, the first law of thermodynamics, the second law of thermodynamics was discovered. So, dahil limited lang yung kaya ng first law of thermodynamics, kaya nang ginawa or na-discover yung second law of thermodynamics. Okay. So, pero hindi mo natin i-discuss yung second law of thermodynamics. First law muna tayo. So, what is heat capacity and specific heat? So, na-discuss na natin to noon. So, just a little recap lang. So, as you can see above the picture, the sand is also receiving the same amount of heat from the sun and the water of the ocean is also receiving the same amount of heat from the sun. Then why is there a difference in the temperature of sand and water? What? Why is this happening? So, yay, the concept of heat capacity plays the impossible role here. So I'll explain to you, don't worry. So as shown in the above picture, the sand gets heated more as compared to water. We can say that for heating the sand, only a few amount of heat is required, while for heating the water, a lot of heat is required. So in other words, sand is not having more capacity to absorb heat, while water keeps on absorbing the heat of the sand. Okay, so let me give you a fun example. So a short-tempered person gets angry very soon, while a calm person who keep on tolerating everything will not become angry soon. So, yung heat capacity ng mga taong yan is, ganun ba yun? So, pag mainit ba yung ulo mo, mas mabilis, mas maliit lang yung capacity ng utak mo? Ganun ba yun? Or yung heat capacity? Kasi umiinit, no? Di ba? Well, it's not the same. Okay, let's continue. Heat capacity is something similar to this. So, the amount of heat required for the same change in temperature is different for different objects. So, iba't iba yung tao, iba't iba yung kapasidad niya. So, iba't iba din yung heat capacity niya. Diba? So, ganun yun. So, now, take the same 1 kilogram of water in this bowl at 20 degrees and increase its temperature to 25 using a burner. Guess what will happen? Will it consume more heat energy or less heat energy? So, the answer is, water will consume more heat energy compared to the same quantity of sand. This happens because water has more capacity to absorb the heat. Okay, so balik na tayo dito. So tapos tayo nito dati, 'di ba? So tapos na tayo sa topic 2 ata to. So sorry, wala tayong video for topic 2. Gagawin natin 'yan later na lang. So from the above example of sand and water, we noticed that heat capacity of sand is less while heat capacity of water is more. That means heat capacity depends on the material of the body. Also, one more thing I would like to add, heat capacity also depends on the mass of the object. So the bigger the mass of the object, the more heat will be absorbed, so its heat capacity will be more. While smaller the mass of the object, less heat will be absorbed, so its heat capacity will be less. Kaya pala yung mga malhilig uminom dyan, di ba? Sabi nila, na mas bakit mas matagal malasing yung malalaking mga tao kaysa sa maliliit na mga tao? So is it because they have higher capacity? Well, parang gano'n na yun. Kasi yung blood mo, mas marami yung dugo ng malaking tao kaysa sa maliliit. So yung blood and alcohol percentage is matagal tumaas yung alcohol percentage sa dugo mo pag malaking tao ka. Pero it doesn't really, may ibang tao din naman siguro na hindi sanay, so madali rin sigurong malasing. Pero kung parehas kayo na sanay, siguro mas matagal malasing yung mas malalaking tao kaysa sa maliliit. Okay, specific heat capacity or specific heat. So, tapos na tayo natin itong i-discuss, topic 2. So, let's continue na lang sa next. So, there are 4 types of thermodynamic processes. So, ano ba yun? We have first, the isobaric process, in which water is heated using burner candle in open vessel. Have you seen this at your home? Okay, so if I hope you have seen this. So, this is the boiling of water in an open vessel. So, the boiling of water takes place at atmospheric pressure only. The pressure neither increases or decreases. So, such a thermodynamic process in which the pressure remains constant is called an isobaric process. So, constant pressure siya. Diba? Kasi yung pressure sa ating surrounding is parehas lang yung atmospheric pressure natin. So, constant yung atmospheric pressure pag nagpapakuloy na tayo ng tubig. Pero pag binago natin yung pressure sa surroundings, so magbabago din yung temperature na bago kumulo yung tubig. Okay, so for example, pababain natin yung pressure siguro. Pag bumaba yung pressure, mas kukulo din yung ating tubig at a lower temperature. Sabi natin mga 70 degrees pa lang, kukulo na yan pag bumaba yung surrounding pressure. Pero sa atin dito sa bahay or sa atin dito, sa lupa, so atmospheric pressure natin is constant, so constant din yung temperature, kukulo siya at around 100 degrees Celsius. So next, we have the isochoric process. So kung makita natin, sinarado natin yung takip ng ating kettle or ng ating, ano ba to? Oh, lutuan. So ano mangyayari? So now I will close the vessel with the help of a lid. Ano mangyayari? Well, in this process, the vessel cooker is closed, meaning the volume of the vessel remains the same. The volume is neither increasing nor decreasing. So here, the boiling of water takes place in some specified constant volume. Thus, the thermodynamic process in which the volume remains constant is called an isochoric process. So wala pagkulo niya kasi sarado siya, takip na takip, walang singaw. So same volume pa rin yung tubig. So yun, tinatawag yun na isochoric process. Okay. Next, we have the adiabatic process. So, adiabatic process example showing piston cylinder walls in which no heat transfer takes place. So, the thermodynamic process in which there is no heat transfer involved is called adiabatic process. So, there is no heat transfer. So, the piston moves up and down. That means expansion and compression takes place over here. But there is no heat exchange occurring between this system and surrounding. Thus, this is an example of adiabatic process. So, no heat transfer, adiabatic. We have the fourth one, the isothermal process. Or iso, same, thermal temperature. So, example, thermal in which water is boiling in open vessel at constant temperature. So, the thermodynamic process which occurs at constant temperature is known as isothermal process. So, na-maintain natin yung temperature. For example, na-maintain natin yan at around 100 degrees. So, constant temperature na yan. So, yan yung isothermal process natin. So, reversible and irreversible process. So, this ice cream can be converted to liquid on heating. And again, it can be converted to ice cream on freezing. So, water can be converted to ice in freezing. On freezing, and this ice can be again converted back to water on heating. So, reversible process. The thermodynamic process which can be reversed back to its original state is called reversible process. Yun yun be. Okay? So, next, we have this wood can be converted to fire, but fire cannot be again converted to wood. So, hindi pwedeng ibalik. So, this is irreversible. Yung itlog, pag niluto mo na, hindi mo na pwedeng ibalik sa kanyang original form. So, that is irreversible process naman. So thermodynamics is really amazing, isn't it, baby? And we can see it in our surroundings too. I hope you have clearly understood what is the first law of thermodynamics. So, naintindihan mo ba, be? Okay. So, that's it. So, thank you for your time and hope to see you again. So, bye! Bye na? Bye? Huh? Bye! Like, subscribe for more videos. Thank you!